saw the little shelter, and they heard the baby's cry. They looked in and saw the parents and the child, and they were amazed that this was happening, just as it had been told to them. They ran to tell everyone what they had heard and seen, and that this baby would be a great leader of his people and of all people. Later, some great chiefs from far away also passed by that lonely place. They knelt down before this child and gave him many gifts, furs of fox and beaver. And so the child would survive and would grow. The newcomer said that this child was also one of us, that this story was also our story, that this child was born for us. In the 1640s, the Christmas story was told for the first time in this part of the world to the Wendat people, who first inhabited this land, by members of the Society of Jesus, the Jesuits, who had come from France to what they considered to be a new world, to tell this story. The words of the carol we sing, "'Twas in the Moon of Wintertime," were originally written by Father Jean de Brébeuf in the language of the people, Jesus Ahatonia, Jesus your King, is what we call it. The tune we use is French, but the words are a translation by an English-speaking Canadian, Edgar Middleton, who translated this in the 19th century. It's considered to be the first Canadian Christmas carol. The Jesuits were deeply convicted that the story of Jesus needed to be told in the language and in the culture of the people who were hearing the story. Of course, that had been happening in Europe and other parts of the world for centuries. European carols and paintings of the Nativity made Jesus part of their world and their story. Things that a Jewish family in Roman-occupied Palestine would have known nothing about, holly and ivy, and ships sailing into Bethlehem, evergreen trees and wassail and candy canes. It all helped to hear the story and to understand, and to make the story their own. But we cannot sing this carol or tell this story in 2018 in Canada without recognizing that the sharing of this story so long ago and the early attempts to express it in ways that were meaningful for people of a very different culture and experience went on a dreadfully different and abusive path. Too often the story of Jesus became a weapon to denigrate or infantilize or dehumanize the people of this land. While I was preparing for this evening, I was hesitant to use the carol and the work by artist Francis Tyrrell that's in the bulletin. Too often we've been too content with this carol and with the way the story was told four centuries ago, and to forget the path we have taken since then. But perhaps the story can give us courage. Courage to once again tell the story of the child of Bethlehem in our own time and in our own place. Every Christmas, I pull out a lovely illustrated book of paintings by the Canadian painter William Kuralek, entitled A Northern Nativity. In each painting, we are invited to find the Christ child and members of the Holy Family in a shed of straw in a western cattle drive, in a dark barn. boxcar in a prairie town. In a broken down car on a highway outside a pulp and paper mill. In a grove of trees across the river from the Parliament buildings lit up in the night sky. On a small fishing boat tied up outside the boathouse in an Atlantic cove. Among the crowds of tourists gazing at the frozen beauty of Niagara Falls in winter. Sitting at a table among the poor at a supper offered by a church on a cold winter night. Where do we find the Christ child? How do we tell the story of this birth and the life of this Jesus in our world? A world still beset by war and injustice, by poverty and inequity. A world ever more deeply framed and determined by technology and artificial intelligence. A world in which even the seasons are now threatened by our own human activity. A world where it's hard to tell stories of angel songs and redemption songs. We need to find courage and language and faith. This ancient story, this child coming among us, God with us, Emmanuel, needs to be told and needs to be heard. It's up to us to find words and to make this story ours in our own lives. We'll come to this table on this holy night. As we come, we continue the story of that child of Bethlehem. We remember his birth, his life, his death, and his rising again. We sit together here in this place of warmth and of embrace, a shelter from the cold of winter, and we share this story and our story, and we share a meal that reminds us of God with us. In whatever our circumstances are this night, no matter who we are or what our story might be, here we know that God is with us, that we are loved with a love like that of a mother holding her newborn child, and the love of one who would give all for us and who calls us to follow in his good path. Unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given. Jesus, Hatunia. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Our profession of faith today is drawn from the opening passage of the Gospel according to St. John.
church that seeks to be a place for all people, and it is the place that is seeking to do so every day.